Hi, welcome to a product review by Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri, presenting this tutorial from Canada. This tutorial, we are going to learn how we can use this W3002 temperature control on DIY more to control AC or DC load and use this as a heater control or cooler control. AC load and wiring, I'm going to show you how to control an AC load and including the wiring. Let's get started with this. DIY More has released these two products, DMW3002. Both of these are exactly the same, but the operating temperature, operating voltage is different. As you can see, this has been labeled at 12 volts and this is 220 volts. It seems also they have 24 volts version. You can use it as a heater control or a cooler control. So in both cases it can be programmed and set. Also, you can have a time delay between the heating and cooling if you want to have some kind of delay before it turns off or some kind of delay before it turns on in that case. Also, it has a feature where you can set the tolerance or correct the temperature if your temperature deviates from the value. These two are, one is DC, the other is AC. From outside you will not notice the difference. So when you turn it around, you will see that this has been labeled as 220 volts and this has been labeled marked as 12 volts. So there is 24 volts. So there is 24 volts version. I have three versions. Now let's open the AC version. So we have microcontroller here. This is AC to DC converter. We have two wires here. And this has been labeled. The red is the live wire. This is the neutral wire or ground. So this is a hot or live wire. And these two are, this is the live or hot wire. And this is the neutral. This neutral, the black, is the same if you pay attention from the top. These two blacks are connected, so when you connect the AC and enters directly exits back, so this is the neutral, and the live also powers this, but the live goes through the relay and exits this way. And this is the NTC temperature sensor, which is connected at this point. So we can close it simply like that. And here we have three buttons here. This is the AC version and that's the DC version. But in terms of functionality, they are exactly the same. So let's focus on this one. Now I have connected 12 volts and the temperature sensor now shows the temperature, the room temperature, which is 22.2 degrees Celsius. When I press this, this shows the start or one temperature. If I press this, this shows the other one. So you can set your upper and lower limit. And this is showing P0. If I press this up, it becomes P1, P2, P3, and then it jumps back to P0. If you wait few seconds, the screen will return back to displaying normal temperature. When I press this P0, press it again, it will display the start temperature. This is the start temperature, P0, press again, start temperature, and we can set it, for example, to 65. So wait and it just goes back to this temperature. Now if I press this, that's 65, the other one is 50. And to set that 50, set the stop temperature, press this P0, go P1, and then press this. When you press it, now this is the stop temperature after P1 when you press it, that's the stop temperature. Let me do it again, P1, and then here, and then you can change the temperature as you wish. So I'm setting it as 50 and leave. Now let's go to P2, press this, P0, P1, and now P2. When you go on P2, this is, when I press this, this is for tolerance correction. Let's say the temperature that you're measuring is a little low or high and you want to compensate it, let's say 1.2 degrees, or add or subtract. So let's say you want to add 1.2 degrees. Let's press this, 2, and then here, and then 1.2. Now 1.2 is added. Every temperature that we are receiving, 1.2 will be added on top of it, so it will compensate it. And if you want subtract, and if you want to subtract it, press this, go down until you see negative. Now that's subtracting from the temperature. So after a while, you will see if this deviates from the temperature and it shows the wrong temperature. So that P2 is for this purpose. Now let's go and remove the P2, fix it back. I don't want to change it. So when it is zero, there is no addition or subtraction with that. Wait. Now let's go to P3. P3 is for setting. When I press this, this is the time delay when the start or stop triggers. It waits. If it is one, it will be 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes. All of these value are, as you can see, it can have up to 10 minutes. It doesn't go up. So what it means is that when the temperature reaches and the relay should turn on and off, if it is 1 minute, it waits 1 minute before turning it on or off. To start preparing this for AC, I have to warn you that when working with AC, it's very dangerous. You have to be very careful and take a lot of precautions. And every step, the power must be disconnected before you work. And if you're unsure how to proceed with this, seek help from a professional. Now, in order to turn on and off something, this is my extension cord. This is the plug. This is in Canada and the US. We have this type of plug. Get in a wire, an extension cord, something like this, and this will go to the wall and cut it somewhere here, which I have done. And in US and Canada, we have the plugs are different, so we know which one is live and which one is neutral. The small one in Canada, the small one is the live one. And if I put it here, you will see that this I've already put it. So the small one is the live or hot, and I've labeled it so I don't make mistake. Now I'm going to this one that goes from to the wall. I will solder it at these two, plus and minus. So I want to make sure that live is connected to the red, and then neutral is connected to the black. So this is for the input, and then I'm going to connect this for my load. At this point, yellow is alive, and then black is the neutral. And here I've soldered the wire here, and I put heat shrink sleeves. So I will heat it up. And also I've connected this, that I connect my load here. At this point, live is connected to yellow. Let me apply heat. ready, and I can connect this to the AC directly. Put this on. I don't know what is the temperature setting, but I'm gonna connect a load here. Now let me test it with the cooler. For the cooler, we will set the same way, start at 65 and stop at 50. So I will set P0 at 65. Let me press this. P0, press it again, now make it 65. 0, press it again, make it 65. I'm holding it. Now it's 65. P1, stop, 50. So press this and go up, and then press this again, and then make it 50. Now it is set at cooler, and you can check it. Start 65, stop 50, as shown here. So because it's now 19 degrees, it's below this. It's a cooler, the control system is not working. So it will not work until the temperature reaches 65. When it reaches 65, it will start. You see that start. Then it will still work and cool it down until it reaches 50, it will turn off. Now I'm applying some heat using my heat gun. And here I'm holding this here, and so you can see it. Pay attention here. So at 65 it turned on, it went way high because it's too hot now. And this will stay on until it reaches 50. So we are cooling it down. This is our cooler or refrigerator, so it should go down until it reaches 50. I'm holding it with hand so it cools down faster. Now, very quick, you will see at 50, it will turn off. Now I'm going for heater. Now start move here. Now start is 50, stop is 65, the same way with AC. Let's start, put it at 50. Press this, P1 is start, press it again, and then set this to 50. And then go up, that's the stop. At this time, set this to 65. Now it is set at 65. Now, because this is heater, we want to keep the temperature between 50 to 65, meaning if the temperature is below the 50, it will be on, and it will keep going until the 65, it will stop until the temperature reaches 65. Now it's 37, and the heater must be on, which is on now. So let me heat it so the temperature reaches 65, it will turn off. At 65, turned off, and it will stay off until it reaches 50. So if I hold this with my hand, so cool it down quickly, very hot. Now pay attention, at 50 it will turn on very quick. So it turned on. Now I'm going to show you the time delay. So to set the time delay, we press set and go up until you see 3 and press this. Now the time delay is 0. You can set up to 10 minutes. These are all minutes. And let's set it at 1 and press this, and let me go to mode 1 and let's set this to 65. And press this and then the stop. I'm going to use it at 50. And exit. I've set this now for cooler, P0 65 degrees. If I press it, you will see P0 and then P1 50. So that's P1. What it means is now this is a cooler. When the temperature reaches 65, it will start turning on. And then when it comes back at 50, it will turn off. Now, at the starting point, I've added a 1 minute delay. Now, when the temperature reaches 65, it will not turn on immediately. It will turn on after 1 minute. Let me show you now. As you can see, the temperature is above 65 and it is not on. The light is on, not on this one. And if it goes below the value, I will try to just heat it up. I will not. It takes a minute. If we keep this up above 65 in over a minute, we will see. Now it should be on, but the counter has started. So as soon as 1 minute reaches, you will see that this will turn on. You see, 1 minute passed, and now because it's above 65 degrees, the cooler started turning on, and it will stay on until it reaches 50 degrees. I'm holding it now with my hand so it cools down quickly. But for 50, it turns off immediately. It doesn't wait for a minute. It's just the delay was for the start. Pay attention, as soon as it reaches, it will turn off. Thank you for watching the review presented by Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you want to get updates of my upcoming videos, you may subscribe now. Hi, welcome to a product review. In this video, we are going to learn how we can use the W3002 temperature.